Hi everyone, it's Vicky here, and today I will be creating a new art journal layout. For my background today, I will be using Pan Pastels. They come packed in this pan format, and they are soft pastels that you can apply with soft sponges. Now, they come in this pack, but there are also some plastic trays that you can place them. They have a nice lid, and they are easy to store and very easy to use if you have them in stored in this format. They come in many colors, and what I like about them is that they are very easy to blend, and that's why they are great for creating backgrounds as well as shading. You can apply them with these tools. They are called soft tools, and you can see that there are so many different sizes of sponges, and you can choose which one you like depending on what you want to do. So for my background today, I'm going to show you how I can use my Pan Pastels to create a quick and easy background. So first of all, I am going to stamp this text stamp, and just to add a little bit of interest on my background, and I am using Versamarking. This is watermarking. It's actually transparent, and all it does is that it applies some kind of stickiness on the page. So now I can apply some Pan Pastels, and you will see that where Versamark was, it will grab more pastel color than the rest of the page, and I will have a nice tone-on-tone look. So now you can see that I will be using my bigger sponge, since I want to cover up a bigger area, and you will see how beautifully they blend together. I apply them super easy. I don't pick up too much paint, and you can see that I move from one color to another without cleaning my sponge. It's very difficult to contaminate them, and even if you move some paint from one pan to another, you can just wipe it off. So I am mainly staying with three colors, which I am going to list below in the details area, so you know which colors I have used for my background. And if you look closely, you will be able to see the text from the stamp that I used at the beginning. Now, just because this is very delicate, I don't know if you can really tell, but you will see the effect since I will do it again with another stamp. Once I'm happy with the background, I am going to clean my sponge. You just wipe it off on a piece of kitchen roll paper. And now I am going to do some stamping. I am using this brick stamp. This is by Prima. And I am going to stamp it again on my background with Versamark ink. I am not going to be neat, as I don't really want to have a square block of bricks. But I really want to create the effect of having a wall as my background. So once I'm finished with all the stamping, I will go ahead and use my Pan Pastels, and this time I am going to use a darker shade, and I am going to go with the sponge all over the stamped areas. And you can see here the effect better of how the Versamark ink grabs the paint and gets darker in this area. Pan Pastels are really easy to use for quick backgrounds, and they really blend perfectly together. So here is the outcome. A closer look, and maybe you can see the effect of the text stamp. And just because these are pastels, you need to somehow fix the paint on your page, and you can use a spray fixative once or twice would be great. However, in my case, I won't be using any fixative, but I will cover the whole background with my gel medium. I am doing that just because I want to use a certain technique of shading later on using my big brush markers. But if you are not using big brush markers for your shading, this stage wouldn't be necessary. So now I'm using my pencil, and I am drawing a template. So this is a boot for my witch, and I am going to cut it out with my scissors. And this is going to be the template for cutting out two identical boots for my layout. So today the layout is going to have a Halloween theme, and although we do not celebrate Halloween here in Greece, that was a theme that was really popular, and everyone was asking for a Halloween layout, so there you go. If you want me to create a certain themed layout on my art journal, then make sure to leave me a comment just below, and I will try to make the most popular ones. So now I have both my boots ready out of black cardstock, and to create my scene I will be using some scrap papers. These are scrap papers from a paper pad that's really old. This is the paper pad I'm talking about, and it's by Basic Ray. It's a really old paper, but I believe it's from 2009. But when you are doing such layouts where you cut and paste paper, it's a great way to use all your old scraps. First of all, I'm using this dark green, and with my scissors I'm cutting out some strips of paper which I am going to stick at the bottom to be the ground. Now, first of all, I will be using all those pattern papers to cut out all the elements for my layout, and then I will use my glue and stick everything down. At this stage, I'm not worried at all about shading. I just want to have all the pieces ready and decide where everything is going to be placed. So now I am using the purple pattern paper, and I have cut out the legs for my witch, and of course I need to give her a dress, so I am using the black cardstock again, and I am going to draw with my pencil a basic witch dress, and I will go ahead and cut it out with my scissors. Now, from the same pattern paper, I am looking for some pattern papers that have more designs on them, and I am going to cut out small pieces which I am going to add on the dress as fabric patches. This is a great way to embellish a witch's dress. And of course, just because this is a Halloween themed layout, I just have to add a couple of pumpkins. So I am drawing with my pencil a bigger and a smaller one, which I am then going to cut out with my scissors. Of course, a proper witch needs to have a black cat, so I will draw a black cat as well. And finally, I will give her a magic broom. Oh, and if you want to recreate this type of layout, but you don't feel confident about your sketching skills, then you can always find some templates online. You just Google images about pumpkins or boots or anything else that you want that you can use as a template. So I am going to put on some music as I am cutting out all those little pieces for my layout, and I'll meet you up again once everything is ready to glue. So this is where I have all the little elements cut out, and I am trying to decide where everything is going to go. Once I am happy with the placement, I am going to use my gel medium and stick everything down. I did cut out the cat's head from her body so I could move the head and she can have her head on an angle. But you will see that at the end I decided to have her looking straight up. Now I decided to add to give her a little witch's hat because I think that's super cute. Now I am pretty happy with the replacement, so I know where everything is going to go and I can put everything at the side. And what I am going to do now is to work on the background just a little bit before I stick everything on top. I will be adding this spider web and I am going to white emboss it. So first of all I am going to stamp it with Versamark ink and then I am going to apply some white embossing powder which I am going to melt with my heat gun. I know where everything is going to go, so at this stage I know where I want the spider web to be. So I need one at the bottom, just behind the broom. Also at the top of this page I have quite a lot of empty space, so I am going to stamp a web there as well. And to bring everything together I am going to stamp once more on the other page. So now it's time to bring everything together and assemble my layout. So I am using my matte medium by Ranger and I'm going to stick everything down. The brush that I am using is nice and soft and it's totally dry. I don't dip it at all at water. Now I get a lot of questions on how you can keep your brushes, the ones that you use with gel medium, nice and soft. Well, I keep them dipped inside the gel medium while I'm working, and when I finish I dip them in a jar of water. So once I finished with the whole layout I then go to the sink and wash them with soap and hot or warm water. Now my brushes, that the ones that I use for gel medium, are always nice and soft, so if you keep maintaining them just like I told you, so they will not get hardened at all. Also at this stage notice how everything looks totally flat. I like the scene and the composition, but to bring everything together you really need to do some shading and highlighting. So once I finish gluing everything down I'll show you how this is done. So now that I've finished gluing everything down, I put my brush inside a jar of water and it will stay there until I finish everything and go to the sink to wash it out. So now I'm using my heat gun to speed up the drying process, and once everything is nice and dry, then I can go ahead and do the shading. You can achieve shading with many different techniques, and I will show you a few. Although I usually use my big brush markers, I will show you that you don't really need to have those, but you can use other mediums to do the shading. So depending on what you can find, and you can decide the way you do the shading. So first of all you can use pan pastels, which are very easy to use, but you need to remember that once you finish shading you need to spray everything with a spray fixative. Applying pan pastels with these little tool brushes are really easy to do, and what I usually do is using a slightly darker color than the area that I want to shade. Pan pastels are not only easy to use, but they are very forgiving. So if you don't like something, you can use an eraser and erase everything off. And just for demoing, I did a little bit of shading on the pumpkins, and you can see how different they look now. They bring everything more to life. So another way you can use is pastel pencils. These are by Faber-Castell, and you can smudge them with your fingers. So I am going to apply it here and smudge it, and you can see how deepened those edges are now on those pumpkins. You can find many different colors, and you can use them for all your layouts. But for today, I will be using my trusted big brass markers by Faber-Castell. I have already demonstrated these big brass markers many times on my videos, but I get a lot of questions about them, so you need to remember that this barrel contains Indian ink. And to be able to smudge the Indian ink as I am doing here with my finger, you need to be working on a non-porous surface, and that is why I covered up the whole background with gel medium. Notice that I go with darker colors all over the areas, and finally I always go with my dark brown. What I love about those markers is that they give me a few seconds to move the ink around and smudge it with my finger so that I can create soft shadings. And once it dries, it dries permanent, so it will not move or react to any other medium that I put on top. This is where I decided to embellish my cat's hat just a bit more. So I am gluing a piece of green paper, and I continue doing my shading until I'm happy with it. Once I'm happy with the shading, I will go on with a black marker, and I'm using my Micron marker, and I will go all around the images. Now, Micron markers, and any marker actually, would work great on an art journal, but there is one tip. You need to remember that everything has to be dry on your page. So no paint and no gel medium should be wet, because actually gel medium is glue, and if the tip of your marker touches gel medium, it will ruin the marker and it will stop writing. So this is a great tip to remember, always have a totally dry page. Once I finish with my black marker, I will go ahead and use my white gel pen to do some highlights, and at this point I'm actually drawing a spider that is coming down from the cat's hat. I did draw the spider web white, just like I did with the other spider webs, and of course the spider is black. I will go ahead and add eyes, white eyes, on the spider later on. I will be working on those boots to embellish them a lot, just because I want those to be the focal point of my layout today. And that's because the quote that I will be using at the end will have to do something with those boots. So I am using my white gel pen to add some faux stitching and bring them more to life, and I wanted to use some gems to embellish them even more, but I didn't have any green ones, so I decided to color the ones that I already had with alcohol markers. I am using Copics here, but this would work great with any alcohol ink or any other alcohol marker that you have. So I am going to add 3 gems on each boot. The colors that I am mainly using are the Halloween colors, so I stay a lot with purples, oranges, and greens. I went a little bit crazy with highlighting here. I also gave my cat a face as well as eyes on my cute little spider. And my layout is pretty much finished. All that's left to do is to add the quote. At the moment I'm using HeroArts alphabet stamp set, but this is quite old and it is discontinued. So you will not find a link to this stamp set below. As always, you will find a full list of all the supplies that I'm using just below in the details area, as well as on my blog. This is an alphabet stamp set that is by Simon Says Stamp, and it's really great because it looks like a typewriter font. So I did stamp with both stamp sets, and I really love this quote. I think it's really cute, and I'm totally happy with how this layout came up. I am also doing some highlighting on those letters, and to finish off my layout, I will stamp the date. I decided to stamp it with a Black Archival link on the side of the broom. And finally, I am adding with the distress paint some little dots just to make her leggings polka dot ones, because I thought that it was very plain and dark. So I wanted to bring this more to life. As you can see, I'm not using a brass, but I prefer to use this tool, which makes a better tiny little dots. So that was the layout for today. I hope you had fun and got inspired, and I really did have a lot of fun creating it, although I don't celebrate Halloween. Here are some close-up photos of the layout today, and don't forget to leave me a comment as well as give me thumbs up on my YouTube channel. And if you are new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe, because this is the way to tell me that you love my videos and you want to see more. For more inspiration, here are two more how-to art journal videos. Click on any of the videos on screen, or if you're watching from a mobile device, you can find links just below in the details area, or you can click the info card that just popped on your screen. Thank you all for watching!